The wacky, the wild, and the weird might just be the best way to describe an annual competition held at Purdue that's known as the Rube Goldberg Machine Contest. Now, from its simple beginnings, this competition has developed and grown under the watchful eye of the Phi Chapter of Theta Tau fraternity.
The Rube Goldberg Contest, the competition here, started in 1949 and successfully ran for 6 years. The contest was resurrected in the early 80s by a few members of Phi Chapter Theta Tau fraternity who found the original traveling trophy.
Teams typically compete in a local regional competition before advancing to the national. Our competition this year, our task is to replace an incandescent light bulb. I'm looking forward to seeing how things shake out at this competition.
This Rube Goldberg competition is really a chance for these students to show their creativity. I think a lot of people get a mistaken identity of engineers, that they're a certain person or a certain type of person. They have a chance now to really be creative, use their engineering skills, but also make it into a bigger picture and a real entertaining picture.
Aside from bouncing balls and falling dominoes, showmanship and theme play just as much an important role in the overall presentation.
So a lot of what we're looking for as judges is not just the physics. The physics is sort of a table stake. But what's important in this competition is to be innovating with those kinetics and take a task and make it an experience for people.
Perennial players at the competition, the Society of Women Engineers, or SWE, took third overall in last year's regional and were looking to get a jump on the competition this year.
Boiler up!
I think we're all very excited. Things have been running very smoothly. There's a few things we just added last night, but I have confidence that it's gonna do pretty well.
We got our machine done. It's completed. We're trying to go through all the test runs right now, see what's working, what's not working. I think we're doing okay.
I think we're better, at this point, we're better off than we were last year. So I have more confidence in our machine this year than I was last year.
The competition was fierce as all the machines went through their paces. SWE decided to accept their first two rounds to count for their score, leaving one more opportunity on the table. In the end, it was the University of Illinois who took top honors and went on to the national finals. But that doesn't mean they were the only winners.
The University of Illinois team, they had a really good machine. They did really well this year. I was really impressed. And I'm sure everybody else was really impressed too. But we did well. We're proud. I'm proud of us. I'm sure we're all proud of ourselves. So it was a lot of fun. It was totally worth it.
No matter what the outcome, Theta Tau's Rube Goldberg competition will continue to challenge Boilermakers as well as students across the country as they thrive for utter inefficiency and in turn entertain the Rube Goldberg and all of us. For Boiler Bytes, I'm Bree Swartz.